Hey there, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to answer the most infamous, most asked question in it seems like crochet history. Does the turning chain count as a stitch? So why is it so hard to find the answer to this question? It's because everything is so contradicting. So as a beginner, you have no idea what's going on, and I completely understand because I have been there. When I first started to crochet, this question confused the crap out of me. The only reason why I know the answer to this question is because I have been crocheting for 3 years and I've crocheted a lot of things, so I've just figured it out along the way. But for you, I want to teach you how to do this now. So right now, I'm going to answer your question plain and simply. So first, let me explain turning chains. The reason why we have these turning chains is to reach the height of the stitch. That way our work isn't all scrunched up on the sides. So for the single crochet, you have a turning chain of 1, and that does not count as a stitch. For the half double crochet, you have a turning chain of 2, and that does not count as a stitch. For the double crochet, you have a turning chain of 3, and that does count as a stitch. So for the single crochet, we chain 1 to reach the height of our single crochet stitch, and when we go to work into the next row, we single crochet into that very first stitch because that stitch just doesn't count as a stitch. So basically, it's just there to reach the height so that it doesn't scrunch together, and it doesn't count as a stitch. So whenever you're going to count your stitches, you just don't count that chain 1. For the half double crochet, whenever you reach the end of the row, you chain 2, and then you begin your next row. I feel like there's a lot of confusion for the half double crochet. Some crocheters count this chain 2 as a stitch while other crocheters don't. But whenever I was in the Certified Instructors Program for the Craft Yarn Council, I learned that this chain 2 stitch actually does not count as a stitch. So you would be crocheting into that very first stitch. So completely ignore this chain 2 here and just count the half double crochet stitches. Now for the double crochet, at the end of each row, you chain 3. And generally, this chain 3 does count as a stitch. So whenever you're counting your stitches, you count this chain 3 just as if it was a double crochet. And then once you work down this row, you work your last double crochet into the top chain of the chain 3 from the previous round. So why is it that we can't find a direct answer to this question? It's because whether a designer decides to make the chain 3 or the chain 2 count as a stitch is completely personal preference. Whenever you chain 3 for the double crochet at the end of the row, you should be skipping that first double crochet of the round, or the first stitch of the round, because that chain counts as a stitch. So it's like that double crochet is a part of that stitch. But whenever you do it this way, you do have these holes on the side of your work. So you can see them here. So you have these holes. And a lot of people just don't like the look of these holes. So what they opt to do instead is they chain 2 at the beginning of the row and they double crochet into that very first stitch. And this way you have more of a straighter edge and you don't have those holes at the end of your work. So your next question might be, well, where the heck do I put my stitch then? Well, if a pattern tells you that the chain 3 does not count as a stitch, then you would double crochet into that very first stitch. If the pattern says the chain 3 does count as a stitch, then you would insert your hook into the second stitch. So that first stitch would be known as a false stitch, so you would skip that and double crochet into that second stitch. And be sure to count the chain 3 as a double crochet at the end once you're making sure that you have all your stitches for that row. And like I said previously, they might tell you to chain 2 and double crochet in each stitch across, and they may say in the notes that the chain two does not count as a stitch, and so you would again double crochet into that very first stitch, and then you would completely ignore the chain two. So you wouldn't count it when you're counting the stitches in your row. And the same goes for the half double crochet and the single crochet. Okay, and that is it for this tutorial on turning chains. Now, I know that seemed really simple, but I think I covered all the questions that you would ask about turning chains. If you have any other questions, please let me know in the comments below. Also, if you are a beginner, which I assume you may be if you're here, I have a free Facebook group that you can join by signing up for my email list. So if you would like to become a part of an amazing community filled with crocheters of all experience levels, but mostly beginners, we would love to have you. The whole point of this group is to be a place where you can get answers. There is no such thing as a stupid question, so don't hesitate to ask anything. I'm always there to answer questions, and if I'm not, the ladies in the group are so helpful. It truly is an amazing community. So again, that link to sign up will be in the description, and I look forward to seeing you there.